What's up, guys? What you're about to see is episode 2 of the Niner Niner Whiskey Aircast. This episode features comedians Aaron Chase and George Ferido from the Buddy System. They run a production company out of Riverside. Funny guys. We have a fun time flying around, talking, and kind of exploring what they do with the Buddy System and what they're all about. So stay tuned, check it out.
When the line froze, what did I see? A bad motherfucker standing next to me with his eyes closed, told he can't see. Trying to follow orders, just gone and be free. Be free like a bird, so today I'ma fly. Bad, bad motherfucker till the day I die. Be free like a bird, so today I'ma fly. Bad, bad motherfucker till the day I die. Yeah! Bad, bad motherfucker till the day I die.
I'm a bad brain Bruce Wayne in the fast lane. Couple J's in the ashtray style, motherfucker.
Yeah, man, I'd be so fucking down.
Is this fucking thing not been recording the whole time, dude?
Whatever. Is that remember?
That one's recording, okay. But this has the audio.
Oh, shit.
Let's start over.
Okay. But when it comes to making a show, there's little things that people don't take into consideration, like the environment. Like, I remember we were doing the hideaway in the beginning. We were trying to figure out what's the best way to set up for the audience. And George realized, like, well, the tables were too close to the stage.
Okay.
And it was freaking people out. And so they wouldn't go sit close up.
Yeah.
So we just pushed the tables back a little bit. More people sat up front. And then all of a sudden, the show was that much better.
Dope.
So there's, like, little things that I think more comedians should take into consideration when setting up a show.
Yeah, that makes sense.
And
that's what the Buddy System's doing. So tell me about the Buddy System again, just in case. Like, what happened? How did the Buddy System come about? How did that start?
So I started running the show, the comedy show at the Hideaway. How long is it? 2-3 years ago?
Probably 3 years now.
Okay.
2.5-ish.
Okay. I mean,
and that has its own history on its own, but we can skip that for another time.
Okay. Yeah, that's whole other thing. But basically, I started running it, and then George noticed that I was running myself into the fucking ground.
Okay.
Like he was saying, when you go to other shows and just one guy running it, usually they're kind of just sitting there.
Right.
I don't know. Is that the best way you would describe it?
Like most people will, not that they just sit there, but I don't think they actually think about how to stack the room to make it successful for comedy.
Okay.
And Aaron was like, understood that, I need people in here so that they're not just comedians. I need to also host. I need to try and have short transitions. So he was trying to do two people's jobs. And I didn't go up and approach him like, hey, man, you need help. Can I help you? I went, hey, man, you need help. I'm going to go sit down. Like, that was my approach. Like,
okay. You
should have a friend to, like, run sound with you. And then, like, 2 weeks later, he still didn't have it. And I was like, dude, do you want me to run sound? Like,
oh, sick.
Like, I just went to help him out because I was like, this is a great room. We can make this a better room. And I didn't want, like, I wasn't trying to run the Hideaway. I was just trying to do comedy. And I had social anxiety, too. So I was like, I just need a job. So
I
sat myself behind the booth and I started running sound. And then everything kind of grew organically from there.
Sick. That's cool.
That's a good way to describe it.
Yeah.
Organic growth. Like, the other thing is finding people that are... I mean, I said it in the beginning of this. Hopefully it was recorded. I don't know.
But yeah.
I said in the beginning was that... And it's no offense, but when you suggested doing this, I didn't fully take it seriously.
Okay.
Until you showed, like... Oh, no, this is real. Like,
yeah.
The amount of people that have come up and been like, oh, do this for us.
Yeah.
It's been insurmountable. And
okay.
So now we're trying to be a little more, or I am, trying to be a little more careful about what we do or not because it's so much work.
Yeah.
But this is amazing. I can't even, like...
Here, we're going to go this way so we can get some cool shots of the snow.
No.
Oh, my God.
So when it comes to, like...
such a California thing, like, look, snow, look, desert.
Yeah, it's crazy, right? So you were saying earlier your favorite thing is seeing comedians and your friends grow as comedians and get funnier and develop
Definitely. Comfort
on stage. And
it's awesome.
I was saying, like, the last interview I did was a guy that owns a CrossFit gym, a good friend of mine, and that was one of our things. It's like, you have a team of people that are trying to punch everybody up. You're trying to, like, support and make them better. And there's so many people in the world, I think, that are trying to bring people down, you know?
Yeah.
They call it, like, that lobster mentality. Like, the lobster's always trying to pull each other down out of the tank.
Yeah.
And I don't like that. You know, I hate trapping people or telling somebody they can't do something. We talked about that a little bit at breakfast, you know, like you like she said you wanted to be a pilot, somebody said you were too short.
Yeah.
They told me like I wasn't good enough at math. You know, and so like I just like the ability is really there, and it's all about work, dude.
Definitely, definitely.
That's why I think people lose it. Is like if you don't put in the fucking work for anything, dude. Being funny, being shit, whatever it is you want to do, your show, it's not gonna happen.
Yeah.
You know, there's one way to success, right?
100% agree.
Yeah.
And it just sucks because especially in the entertainment industry, there's so many people that like to project their own insecurities onto us.
Yeah.
Like you know, they're themselves negative people, so they're like, oh, the buddy system is just trying to take over and do, you know, make themselves popular. But it's like, no, we're legitimately just trying to offer a platform. There wasn't anything there before we got there. Like,
yeah.
We're just trying to bolster and create a community because the small comedy communities so far are my favorite places to be. We went to, I shouldn't say we, but I went to Denver, and they have a very small comedy. Like, I saw the same 18 comics every day of that week that I was there at every mic that I went to. And I was like, this is cool. And they were all very nice, very approachable. Whereas, like, you go to L.A., you'd be lucky if you see the same 8 comics every day. You know, maybe every other day or every 2 days.
Yeah.
And it's just, it's so big, it's so deep that you don't get to develop a connection in a 4-seater airplane over the desert.
right,
like,
yeah.
You don't get opportunities like that.
And that's one thing that was cool about the buddy. Like, when I started doing those mics, and again, we said this earlier, but I don't think I hit the record button. I would go to L.A. and do a comedy show or do an open mic, and by the time it's my turn, because I know they're fucking skipping me, dude, like,
yeah.
Because their friends are going.
Yeah.
Then everybody's stoned or fucking drunk out back, and I'm performing for 2 people, and I'm trying to prep for like a 10-minute set the next night, and I don't get any feedback, so I wasted my time. I wasted my fuel.
Yeah.
That, you know?
That's actually a big, what you just said about letting your friends go up. Obviously, like, you have friends you want to support. Like, you have closer friends than others, so we have friends that could pop in for other shows.
Right.
But especially at open mics, there's this integrity that I think George would agree. There's this integrity that, like, nobody skips the line. Nobody's better than anybody else.
Yeah. I like that.
At a mic, we're all the same.
Yeah.
Like this, I know people have heard about this, and I haven't talked about this in a while, but, like, I will cut your mic, like, if you're going over time and we're at an open mic. Like,
yeah.
I don't care if we're homies. You have this amount of time. You're not better than anyone.
Right.
Like, you're taking other people's time at this point. So it's like, I will do that to Aaron. I hold everyone to the same standard. Like, I put myself in the bucket. I don't bump anyone. Sometimes I'll go last.
Yeah, like, I've noticed that, too. I think I've seen you go last or, like, next to last. Yeah, I've seen that.
Like, I understand that I'm not there for me, and I'm trying to just do what I want to do and watch people get funnier. Like, it's fun.
You know what? Yeah. That's actually a really... So, ego.
Ego
is super... It fucking destroys people in this business, in my opinion. I think people just need to check their egos. Like, it's not all about you.
Yeah. So, I wish I could... Okay, so... There's these people in the industry, I don't know their name, I know, like, Barry Katz or some shit. Like, my cousin worked with all these guys, and he worked with this guy that produced a shit ton of shows. He wrote for all these people, and my cousin, Buckstar at the time, you know, his name's Greg, he's like, I would go up there and be like, I want to be funny, I want to be the shit, I want to be the best, I want to do this. And the guy's like, dude, put your ego in check.
Yeah.
You're here to be a service for these people that paid to see you.
Yeah.
And if you think about it from a service aspect, you're there to serve and give more to these people, you're going to be better. And he said it totally changed his sets and his mentality.
Yeah, that's something that I meet comedians that are like, well, I'm the funny one on stage. Fuck the audience. And it's like, if without the audience, you're just a douchebag jerking himself off on stage.
Yeah. You got a product, and if the people don't buy it, you're not doing it right. You got to change your product, right?
Yeah, and I think there's an ebb and flow between the comedian and the audience. Obviously, the comedian deserves respect, but the audience also deserves respect, and you need to find that balance. That was an important thing. I remember when I first started, when I bombed, I was mad at the audience.
Okay.
And now I just get mad at myself. Like, I'm the only... I'm the one who wrote the jokes.
Yeah.
So...
Or even the rhythm of what you told it. That's why I asked if you play drums. They say drummers are good comedians because of their timing.
Right. No, I'm a bass player, so I don't know if
that's... still timing.
Yeah, that's timing.
All right, check this out, dude. You want to fly the plane? Just steer it around. I know you're sketchy, dude.
Okay.
We're cool. So just put, right there.
Okay.
And just go ahead and turn right a little bit.
Okay. Oh my god.
Yeah. Yeah, you're flying, dude. Is George freaking out?
No.
Okay.
Right. George is calm as fuck with this, in these situations. This scares the fuck out of me. Oh my god.
The business side's coming out of George. He's like, all right, I know exactly what we're going to do if shit goes bad.
Oh my god.
No, honestly, like, it's one of those things. Like, I've always had a fear of flying, but I had to get over that early.
Let's do a hard lift.
And yeah. When I was a kid, I had to fly because my parents were divorced, so I had to fly in between islands because I'm from Hawaii.
Sick.
So my parents lived on different islands, and I had to fly, but I was scared. So as soon as I get on a plane, in my head, I'm like, if I die, this is where I'm dying. Like, there's no point trying to freak out over it or anything. Like,
whatever, huh?
This is where I am. Yeah, I try to stay present. And
yeah.
Because I have a tendency to kind of, like, fixate and overthink things, so I just try to stay present. I was going to say earlier when we were mentioning...
All right, straighten it out. Okay.
We're mentioning ego that, like...
Let's go this way.
Okay.
I'm quick to squash an ego because I don't really have one. I know people think that, like, I'm big-headed or anything, but it's like, I do a lot of things that keep me humble. I do comedy for one. I bomb regularly. I do jujitsu. I get strangled by everyone.
Oh, sick. Okay.
Like, climbing is always going to be difficult. There's a humbling aspect to rock climbing in general just because there's always going to be a route you can't do.
Right.
So it's like, I don't have room in my life for ego, so I don't have room in my life for your ego.
Definitely. Yeah. I'm the same way. It's all relative.
Yeah.
Like... I was like a fairly good tennis player. People are like, oh, you're the shit. And I'm like, yeah, compared to this guy. But compared to this guy, I fucking suck, dude.
Yeah.
I wouldn't even get a game off of him.
Yeah.
You know, it's all, or like, oh, do you lift heavy? Well, for me, yeah, I just started, you know.
I tore my shoulder into 19 pieces, but yeah, I kind of lift heavy. Like.
Yeah, you're good.
Okay.
we'll go out this way a little bit. Through that valley right there. And we're going to head back right now because I got to get back. Yeah, it's all, yeah, it's, for me, if I started it, I mean, when I first started working out, I remember I was benching 95 pounds for like 4 reps. And then I was hitting, like, at one point, I was hitting, like, 315 for, like, 4. So 95 was heavy then, 315 was heavy now. It's just relative, you know?
Yeah. I recognize that the buddy system and Aaron and I and most of us are just big fish in a very little pond. Like, I understand then and that there's bigger ponds to go to, but it's like I'm just trying to make this pond nice for a lot of people so that they can also grow in this pond and then jump ponds. Like, I'm not trying to hold anyone back. I want everyone legitimately to succeed.
I'm going
to
go ahead and take it back.
Okay.
I'm going to get on these guys. You did a good job.
Thanks, man.
Yeah,
when it comes, like, what George was saying about flying and fear and shit, I think we react to it differently.
Okay.
So, first off, I'm aware that we're filming and this is meant for entertainment. It is far more entertaining to see a guy freak out than be like, I got this.
Yeah.
But there's some genuine, like...
No, I know you're scared, dude. I can tell.
Like, for me, my reaction is mostly, it's like excitement mixed with fear, mixed with accepting, like, if we go down, this is a badass way to go down.
Yeah. I've always thought that if I die, I'm going to die doing what I love.
This is super dope. Seriously, thank you. This is amazing.
Yeah, but I'm glad you guys are like.
Do you ever have that feeling when you're driving on the freeway or when you're, like, in a tall space or when you're in a plane where there's this little feeling in you that's like, what if I just jumped out?
No.
No, oh, there's a fucking cabin.
This is how you grow weed on 4 acres.
SoCal Approach, Beach 23999 Whiskey.
23999 Whiskey, SoCal Approach. Go ahead.
We're at BE-23-24 Slant Alpha, 10 miles to the south of the Spirit Airport, headed to Riverside Airport for flight following.
You said Riverside?
Roger.
Oh yeah, I remember you. 999 Whiskey, squawk to 0233.
Do you know any of these guys personally?
0233, 999 Whiskey. I know one guy, but I would never talk to him.
Dude. Number 23999 Whiskey's radar contact 7 miles northwest San Bernardino Airport. Altitude indicates 4,800. Stay at or above 4,500 for traffic.
At or above 4,599 Whiskey.
999 Whiskey. Thanks. I'll give you a traffic call when you get closer. The Ontario altitude is 3032.
3032, 99 Whiskey. Roger.
Heading 230. Descend and maintain 9,000.
Right. Heading 230. Descend, maintain 9,000.
Yeah, like once you get to this area, it's like constant work.
So, are
number
people...
Number 6, Charlie, turn left, heading at 080. Vectors for
the
traffic.
The main guy's not, no.
Left
he's
zero,
sitting in a thing, he's got a screen.
Number 735, Alpha Victor,
and like Kelly said, oh, contact this frequency, they're probably sitting this far apart. He just handles a different airspace.
How does this... 395, traffic 6 miles south of your position, east, north, eastbound. 8,500.
How did this work before all the technology?
Like with the VORs and things that I was telling you.
Oh,
that little bicycle.
Check Ontario, 3032.
much easier with this, dude. So you probably did a shit ton more math then. You know,
395, you are now on a 999 Whiskey. Your traffic is 12 o'clock and 1 mile, only one aircraft indicating 3,700.
Roger that. I got the traffic insight, and we also have Charlie for Riverside.
Our 999 Whiskey, cancel altitude restriction.
Cancel the restriction, 99 Whiskey. See the plane over right here?
Charlie,
like right over
right
that building?
Zero,
yeah.
Zero. Zero.
That's the guy he was warning us about. So he's going to land.
395, turn left, heading 180.
Left 180, southwest 3095.
We got a bogey.
I'm sorry, what?
Top Gun, they call the bogey
yeah,
right there.
Yeah, Jester's dead.
Yeah.
Oh, he's fucking around?
Yeah, he's out just flying.
Oh, okay.
Below us now, yeah.
Probably going to do a fight with his wife.
You are
like,
at 900,500, is that right?
Anytime I hear bogey, I'm like, oh, we're getting shot down.
No, we're shooting somebody down if there's a bogey, dude. I want that alpha mentality up. I'm shooting somebody. I'm not getting shot.
Southwest 3095, traffic is over.
Right now we're doing 144 miles an hour.
500 indicated type is unknown, fast mover.
Late.
Number 6, call Charlie, reduce speed to 190 or less. Lower as soon as I can.
Look at this.
190, 6, come
on. I ran a little bit.
What the fuck?
Oh, my God. Turn left
oh,
heading
fuck you. Oh, shit.
All right, that was nothing. That was nothing.
We got it. Number 6, call Charlie, turn right heading 190.
Oh, my God.
Right 190, Charlie, 6, come Charlie.
Hey, probably the funniest shit I ever did. It was the middle of the night, and I was coming back
number
to pick
six,
up
Charlie, when
my
you
cousin
are
in Arizona. He's asleep over there like this, and he fucking played a joke on me. So I get all my hopes in my head. I'm gonna fucking die. Everybody screamed, dude. Everybody wanted to see like this far. He's like, dude, it was the funniest shit to go from dead to sleep and do a negative dive.
2 miles, 6,600 indicated. You're just going to go around him, and you can now descend and maintain 4,000.
Yeah, it was hilarious.
I think it's so it's like unnatural. It doesn't feel natural.
Yeah.
It feels like I'm not supposed to. Human beings are not supposed to naturally be
this guy.
Just
in the air.
Nothing.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Number 5 Alpha Victor Radar.
Like,
terminated to
the power and
all.
I'll go up so it's kind of positive for it, and it's even a bigger.
South of 3095, turn right heading 190.
Right 190, southwest.
I got to keep it fairly G-rated.
November 6, South Charlie, should you see him? Traffic here following is 1 o'clock, 6 miles southbound.
Number
6, South Charlie, maintain visual separation from and follow that traffic. He's landing runway 26 right. You're clear to the approach to runway 26 left.
Like, how do you have a eulogy for that guy?
South of 3095, traffic.
Would you do that? Would you base jump? No.
Fuck that.
Yeah, me neither.
And 76 unit, you copy that runway 273 to land number 2.
Yeah, I wouldn't base jump.
Roger, copy 76 unit number 2.
Base jump, you have like a second, right?
And November 99 whiskey, extend your downwind off fire base.
Release, basically.
Extending downwind 99 whiskey. Yeah, I even... I've heard of people...
704 Alpha Tango, extend your downwind off fire base.
We'll
extend our downwind, you call our base, 4 Alpha Tango.
Cessna 6 Mike, runway 27 taxi, yeah, Echo Alpha.
Yeah, I've heard about people like flying between canyons.
November 99 or Whiskey, make 1 left 360.
And smashing into to mountains and shit.
Say again, 99 Whiskey.
Or 99 Whiskey, make left 360.
Left 360, 99 Whiskey.
Cessna 45 Yankee, same intention.
Yeah, they get
into
some crazy shit. You feel okay?
45 Yankee, runway 27 taxi via Alpha, no delay. You're in front of a Cessna that's taking echo.
Well, that could be Alpha, no delay.
This is like a 45 degree bank.
Yeah, man. Clear to land if able to touch your base.
Oh, cool.
Is that for 4 Alpha Tango? It was bubble.
Four Alpha Tango, affirmative. Start your base now if you're able. Runway 27, clear to land.
We'll start our base now. 4 Alpha Tango.
Helicopter 2 Alpha Zero, make 1 right 360.
1 right 360 for 2 Alpha Zero.
You can feel
anybody else
like,
besides calling on the ground shot on tower?
This makes holding the camera difficult.
Oh, fuck. Oh shit, man. If they actually send people to Mars, I don't think they can go.
Ground net standby.
It's a one-way trip.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everybody gets one landing, is what they say.
Oh, fuck.
November 76, Julia left that golf, same intentions.
Going over to display or area.
99 Whiskey, base approved, spacing looks good, runway 27 clear to land.
Oh, roger, 27 clear to land, and we got the traffic in sight, 99 Whiskey.
Departures at the end, about 2 arrivals, and I'll get you out.
Yeah, because we're causing a lot of global warming here.
Is that guy want to do time? You need to sign up. That's funny.
Helicopter to office here. Extend.
Yeah, I want to be known through all these guys that when I'm flying and I go 999 Whiskey, they would be like, oh, is this the comedy guy? I did, one time I was coming back from Vegas, like I said, I get bored, so I start doing voices. So
that's 90131, Riverside Ground, runway 27, taxi vehicle,
Texas
Alpha.
Voice, and the guy pops on with the same voice.
Yeah.
And I'm like, dude, he's fucking with me back.
That's 931,
these, guys don't ever say shit except for like what you hear now.
Yeah.
The guy must have been slow and he's like, where are you coming from, boy? And like, just on and on and on. I had to keep this shit up for like an hour, dude. I was scared to change my voice.
Yeah, the landing is way scarier than the going up.
Yeah.
And helicopter up here. If you want to hold there or
here. You'll see right here, it says wheels.
The Archer over there.
That's just people if they have a retractable gear to make sure they have their wheels down, like a reminder. It's not on all airports. It's just, it's funny that
Roger.
Have people fucked up?
704 off the tango, hold short of text way
alpha. Belly land that shit.
Holding short alpha, 4 off the tango.
And anybody else called on ground?
It's kind of a fun way to land.
Yo, the landing's way fucking scary. Holy shit.
We're good, we're good.
Okay.
704 off the tango, taxi straight in via golf, monitor ground.
Taxi straight in, golf, monitor ground, 4 off the tango.
Archer 262, Charlie Bravo, Riverside ground, runway 27, taxi via Bravo Alpha, standby, what's your request?
That ain't no thing.
That was very nice.
Thank you.
That was smooth as fuck, but like...
Yeah, it's sketchy coming in, dude.
Turkey,
and then how you were saying, like, it wobbles.
99 Whiskey left at golf, same attention.
We're going to head over to transit, 99 Whiskey.
99 Whiskey, taxi straight in via golf, monitor ground.
Monitoring ground, straight in via golf, 99 Whiskey.
Particular.
So what happens is when, or the turbulence leads off the wind, it starts circulating between it, and it creates like a cushion of air. They call it ground effect. So that's why you'll notice people come in all sketchy, and right when they get in the ground effect, it's like,
whew. Anybody else on?
That was dope.
Good, man. I'm glad you guys liked it. It's fun for me too, man. I love doing this show.
That's 291, the Bonanza is departing to the south, runway 27, clear.
This for sure, dude.
Fascinating.
For sure. This is just, even if you didn't do anything with it, this is cool way to just hang out with your friends.
For sure, dude.
I mean, sure, it's very high maintenance for the pilot, and he can't really hang for a little bit, but.
Yeah, yeah.
This is definitely.
It looks like the pattern's going to be cool now. What's your next request? I got about 7 departures at the end.
Have you ever watched Hot Ones on YouTube?
Okay, yeah, Papa, no, hold your position. There's a Cessna departure. I'll get you.
It's an interview show. Yeah, you know what? I'll send it to you. It's an interview. The host and whoever the people being interviewed, they eat these wings with hot sauce.
I did hear about this. So
yeah.